You search for truth in poetry. You search for truth in a place that is ambiguous, ambivalent. You find truth in eroticism. You find truth in the core of who you are. And that is what Paradiso at its heart is.
Suddenly, Octavio Paz in Mexico, everybody was talking about it. Cortázar in Paris. This novel was compared to the novels of Marcel Proust, to giants of literature in Europe and anywhere.
Para unos, Paradiso es un libro hermético y detrás del hermetismo hay una actitud antipopular. Para otros, es un libro católico y detrás del catolicismo hay una actitud antisocialista. Y para otros, es un libro de homosexual y un homosexual es un ser peligroso para el hombre nuevo en la sociedad cubana.
Dear Aloy, you must understand how much I have suffered. I live in fear, overwhelmed by melancholy.
José Lezama Lima came of age in 1930s Cuba, a time of political unrest in a nation struggling to find an identity.
Un país frustrado en lo esencial político puede encontrar su destino por cotos de mayor realeza. ¿Cuáles son esos cotos de mayor realeza? El trabajo intelectual, es decir, volcarse hacia adentro, buscar las esencias de lo cubano, alejado de los estereotipos comunes. Lezama tenía terror a lo turístico, a la palmera, a la mulata, a la maraca, al bongó. Todo era suyo, él era exactamente el hombre que lo podía gustar todo, disfrutar todo hasta en exceso, devorarlo y convertirlo en una literatura cubana distinta.
Lezama es una figura legendaria, mitológica de la cultura cubana. Quienes no lo han leído hablan de Lezama, se acercan a él, porque es realmente una figura que ya trasciende su literatura.
Es un escritor que formó parte del boom de la nueva novela latinoamericana. Es tal la riqueza de ideas en Lezama, es tal la riqueza metafórica de su obra, que puede ser leído en cualquier parte del mundo.
That he is not only a great Cuban writer and Latin American writer, he's a great writer of the world.
Creía en una cosa fundamental, la literatura. Depositó tanta esperanza en la literatura.
Lezama convirtió en poesía hasta las piedras que le pusieron en el camino.
He saw in Fidel Castro's revolution the triumph of Cuba's finest aspirations.
The revolution begins in a period of great euphoria, the triumph over militarism, the triumph over an authoritarian dictator that had been backed by the United States. By 1961-62, after the Bay of Pigs invasion, you have a different kind of state emerging. And it doesn't emerge immediately, it emerges slowly. But it becomes very clear to intellectuals, writers, and artists, probably first, that this is an authoritarian state.
Dear Aloy, we wake up and mother tells me, I dreamt that it was raining when Aloy was leaving in the morning. Then I called her house on the phone. Aloy, did you arrive okay? Did you get too wet? I should confess that mother telling the story of that dream in her enchanting simplicity saddened me all day.
Family separation cut Lezama to his core as his sisters went into exile. Soon, he began to experience an exile of his own.
Que no confundan la serenidad de la revolución con debilidades de la revolución. La sociedad socialista no puede permitir ese tipo de degeneraciones.
Homophobia had existed in Cuba for a long time. The revolution, in order to become very nationalistic, decided homosexuals were not real Cubans.
Homogeneity is the goal. This allows for the Cuban state to carry out really unprecedented attacks on homosexuals, rounding people up just on suspicion that they might be, sending them to labor camps.
The UMAP were concentration camps, and they brought many homosexuals. The idea was that if they worked alongside the peasants there, they were going to cure themselves from that disease. That was a very extreme moment in the history of Cuba.
Quietly homosexual, Lezama married his secretary, Maria Luisa, well into his 50s, but became a target of government intolerance with the publication of Paradiso in 1966.
Se regó como una pólvora por toda la ciudad hasta el punto que la gente iba, por ejemplo, a la Biblioteca Nacional a pedir el libro del capítulo 8. No sabían el nombre, pero sabían que había un capítulo 8 que era un capítulo muy fuerte.
Yo creo que no había otra novela que tocara el asunto homosexual con tanta valentía. No había surgido nada así en lengua española. Cuando yo leí Paradiso, y yo fui un defensor de Paradiso, un defensor fanático, frenético.
The complaints of some officials made the government pull out Paradiso out of the bookstores. Some people say that they gave it to Fidel, and Fidel read some lines and realized that the novel was so difficult that nobody was going to understand anything anyway. And he said, go ahead.
Dear Aloy, today I received a telegram from Stockholm, Sweden to publish my novel Paradiso. It is almost ready to be available in English, French, and Italian.
Yo creo que fue su momento, digamos, de esplendor en el sentido de que se publicó Paradiso, fue muy reconocido, pero entonces vinieron los acontecimientos ya a partir del caso Padilla.
Padilla's book was given an award in 1967, which was, you know, the highest award that could be given at the time by Casa de las Américas. That prize is given to him by a jury headed by Lezama Lima, of all people. He was going to champion the writing that would be the best, but also the kind of writing that intellectuals are supposed to do, which is critical writing.
Pasaron años muy difíciles. Ese era el comienzo de una especie de catarro malo que tuvo la cultura cubana, una especie de influenza que tuvimos todos y a todos nos tocó.
It became known as the Gray Period, and in the atmosphere of intolerance, Lezama Lima was silenced, ostracized. His books disappeared from shelves. His name was removed from library archives.
Empieza un periodo muy difícil, periodo que llega hasta su muerte. Un periodo en que dejan de visitarlo muchísimas personas, incluido algunos que al parecer habían sido grandes amigos. Sobre la casa de Trocadero empieza a flotar una atmósfera de sitio no grato a las autoridades.
No sabíamos mucho de él, como ya le dije, pero lo que nos extrañaba mucho era que uno no lo sentía en el ambiente de televisión, en el periódico. No se veía esa publicidad con relación a las cosas de él.
Dear Aloy, I live in terror. The past week has been the most tragic and desolate that I have spent in my life. I live in ruin and desperation.
They rendered him anonymous. They rendered him invisible. They rendered him powerless to shape or participate in Cuban letters. So he went from being someone that was renowned worldwide to being nobody.
Fue un final muy triste el de Lezama, completamente aislado en su casa de Trocadero, sintiendo que estaba solo en buena medida, aunque siguió efectivamente escribiendo a pesar de todo.
¿Con qué seguro paso el mulo en el abismo? Lento es el mulo, su misión no siente, su destino frente a la piedra, piedra que sangra. La ceguera.
Yo creo que la resistencia de Lezama, que yo creo que tiene mucho que ver con ese poema, Rapsodia para el mulo, paso es el paso del mulo en el abismo, sacando pequeñas chispas con los cascos de la roca. O sea, yo creo que la vida de Lezama fue eso.